There's a story in which a guru who was residing by the side of river, and he was walking towards the river with his disciples, and there was a group of people shouting at each other in anger. And guru asked the students, why do they shout when they are in anger? And each one gave a different answer, and they were not convincing the guru. So guru said, when you are in anger, you are moving away from each other. That means your hearts are distancing from each other. So to cover the distance, you are shouting. This is what happens. Just if you think of it, yes, it is very true. Because when we are in anger, we shout. Why do we shout? Let us try to talk softly when we are in anger, and we check that. So the guru's explanation is, the hearts are moving away from the persons. So to cover the distance, they are shouting, which is not necessary. They should not have, first of all, anger. So we are losing that calmness, so we shout. And he says, when people are not in anger, or when people are in good mood, or they love each other, or they like each other, what do they do? They talk softly, because hearts are coming close to each other. Sometimes they don't even talk. They whisper, they talk softly, they whisper, or they don't even talk sometimes, because their eyes speak. So the mind is, because the distance is very small when they like each other, that's why they whisper, and their hearts are closer and they look at each other. So this is a beautiful explanation why we shout when we are in anger, and how this soft talk develops more love between people. So after the guru explained this, this is the secret of shouting when we are in anger. So which we should not do. So what do? We all shout. So we learn a good point from this, and Bhagavan says, yes, you remove your anger from your mind. Only then you will think of that Atma. Otherwise, you will be thinking of the person who made you feel angry, and you will be planning to attack him back. So these kinds of thoughts will be going around, and you will not keep your mind calm, and you will not think of Atma and Paramatma. So the anger has to be removed. And raising voice, that is not good. That is not a good manner. So that how you can talk softly. So this is what rishis do. You know, when we look at rishis, sadhus, you can find this. They have always have a smile on their face, and they talk very softly to everyone. And we find the compassion in their voice too. That is because the heart is full of compassion, because the heart is filled with God. So there is a positivity. So this is what we should learn from the sages, from the saints. So this story can be told children, be shared with children, because they can control, while growing up, they can control their anger. Because the children nowadays, because what we pick up in our young days only are growing as we become bigger. So how to control anger has to be taught to the children, because they, if we don't give, or if we don't buy what they want, they get angry very quickly. They become very angry very quickly. So we should make them understand how the wants should be limited. Whatever you have, you be happy with it. and don't feel bad or don't feel sad when you don't get it. So don't get into anger mood and don't get into that. Then they start, no, I don't like you. They'll say that. I don't, whether it's a father or mother, they say that, have listened to the children. So let them not say all that because it is hurting the parents. So it is in our hands. Children can be taught this at the younger age, and they can be beautifully brought up with good values. Let them remove anger from. So if they remove anger from, there will not be hatred, there will not be enmity, there will not be frustration, and there will not be any more negative qualities. In Pasuram, this is Pasuram from Tiruvaimozhi by Nammazhar. He gives explanation on this sloka and he gives us how to concentrate on God. Amarar thozhappaduvanai anaithulagukkum piranai amara manathinul yogu punarndu avan thannodu ondraga amarathuniya vallarkal uriya alladavarellam amara ninaindu irundaadi alatruvade karmame. So in this sloka Nammazhar explains, even if devotees do yoga and think in their minds that their soul and he are the same, they will not be able to join him. But those who, without expecting any benefit, think only of the highest Lord of the whole world, worshipped by gods in the sky, and who sing, dance and prattle his names, will join him. So he says, you do yoga, but how do you do yoga? How Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita. But even when you do that yoga, you should not have any expectation. So those who do without any expectation, though you do yoga, meditation, but that should not be like even tapas. The rishis did not do any tapas for their own sake. Their wish was only to have darshan of God. So let it be like this. Whatever you do, whether you do meditation or any other form of worship, you don't expect any result from that. Instead, you think of him and you sing, dance and prattle his name. So keep singing his name, keep chanting his name. He will show you the path. Which path? The path for moksha. He will have you with him. That is what Nammazhar explains in this pasuram. So let's follow all this and lead a very peaceful life.